Modern computing is riddled with stories of gender bias, boys' toys, and even wartime successes for the likes of men. But what about women? Without Lady Ada Lovelace, you might not be watching this right now. Hey, computer lovers, Trace here for DNews. We live in a world where we interact with computers all the time. And I'm not just talking about your smartphone. Computer systems are in everything, cars, air conditioners, washing machines. But without the mathematical curiosity of this woman and a chance encounter she had at a party, we might not be here right now. This is Augusta Ada Byron, the Countess of Lovelace, but most just call her Ada Lovelace. She was one of the first computer programmers, but was born in 1815, way before computers as we know them were invented. At the time, during the Industrial Revolution, new inventions were happening left and right. They were usually used for one thing. Sewing machines sewed. Steam engines powered a factory. But with one mathematical invention and a single academic paper, Lovelace cemented herself in the history of computer programming. Ada's mother encouraged her to study mathematics as a child, hoping to drive her away from the unpredictable poetic ambitions of her father, the English romantic poet Lord Byron. She merged her creative and analytical ambitions, designing boats and flying machines, but it wasn't until she met Charles Babbage, a professor of mathematics at Cambridge, that she began to express her mathematical intellect. Babbage had an idea for a calculating machine called the analytical engine. Lovelace's interest was piqued, and the two started a correspondence. The thing is, Lovelace had no real training as a mathematician, so by corresponding with Babbage and other mathematicians, she hoped she could learn as much as she could. Eventually, an Italian engineer, Luigi Federico Menabrea, wrote a paper on Babbage's analytical engine. He wrote it in French. Lovelace knew French, so she spent months translating and notating Menabrea's paper. In the end, her notes were three times longer than the actual work, and she understood the workings and possibilities of the analytical engine better than even Babbage, its inventor. What's more, within her super detailed notes, she created a way for the engine to calculate Bernoulli numbers in steps. I know that doesn't actually sound like much, but it was the invention of the first computer program. And even before the digital computer we know today was invented, Lovelace understood its power and limitations, writing, "The analytical engine can do whatever we know how to order it to perform. It can follow analysis, but it has no power of anticipating any analytical relations or truths." She related the computer program to a loom. It could do anything. Lovelace pushed the idea of the engine's abilities beyond simple number crunching and into actual computing. This was the 19th century, though. Another mathematician wrote a series of letters to Lovelace's mother, expressing concern that women, because they weren't as physically strong, shouldn't exert themselves so heavily in the area of scholarly application. He was obviously very wrong about the physiology of men and women and their ability to study math, but ironically, Lovelace did die of cancer at the age of 36. Regardless of some criticism, because of Lovelace's translation and the notes on that analytical engine and her correspondence with other mathematicians, people began to think of these machines as more than just a hulk of single-function engineering. Even though she was never formally trained, other mathematicians of the day thought highly of Lovelace's work, and her notes and the translated paper was published in Taylor's Scientific Memoirs with her initials AAL. Over the next 100 years, Babbage's name wore on, but Lovelace's was relatively obscure until the 1940s. Today, computer programs are running everywhere we look, and some of them can even be written in a programming language called Ada. Lovelace was the first to realize that a computer, a machine, a series of switches, could do something way more complicated than just one thing. With the brain of both an artist and a mathematician, Ada Lovelace showed us all what a computer could be. If you want to know more about an animal that has also changed the field of science, check out this video on Coco the gorilla.
She was born at the San Francisco Zoo on July 4th, 1971. She's been working with teacher Dr. Penny Patterson, then a doctoral student in developmental psychology at Stanford University, since she was just a year old.
Any other scientists, engineers, researchers, or people we should profile? Let us know in the comments. Keep coming back here every day, and please subscribe so you get more DNews.